Welcome, beloved of God, to St. Paul Evangelical Lutheran Church. As we celebrate our fifth Sunday after Epiphany, welcome those who are able to be here in this very cold morning, and those who are watching us from home, we welcome you. We begin with our order of confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose voice is upon the waters, whose mercy is poured out upon all people, whose goodness cascades over all creation.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin, trusting in the abundant grace of God. Holy God, you search us and know us. You are acquainted with all our ways. We confess that our hearts are burdened by sin, our own sins, and the broken systems that bind us. We turn inward, failing to follow your outward way of love. We distrust those who are not like us. We exploit the earth and its resources, and fail to consider generations to come. Forgive us, gracious God, for all we have done and left undone. Even before the words are on your tongues, you know them. Receive them in your divine mercy. Amen. How vast is God's grace! For the power and the promise of Christ Jesus, our sins are washed away, and we are claimed as God's own beloved. Indeed, we are forgiven. In the wake of God's forgiveness, we are called to be the beloved community, living out Christ's justice and the Spirit reconciling peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the one.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Everlasting God, you give strength to the weak and power to the faint. Make us agents of your healing and wholeness, that your good news may be made known to the ends of your creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone. Our first lesson this morning comes from the book of Isaiah. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like a stubble. To whom then will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their hosts and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Word of God, word of life. We will read Psalm 147 responsively. Hallelujah! How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor God with praise.
The Lord rebukes Jerusalem and gathers the exiles of Israel.
The Lord heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
The Lord counts the number of the stars and calls them all by their name.
Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to God's wisdom.
The Lord lifts up the lowly, but casts the wicked to the ground.
Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music upon the harp to our God.
Who covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain from the earth, making grass to grow upon the mountains.
God provides food for the cattle and for the young ravens when they cry.
God is not impressed by the mighty of a horse, and has no pleasure in the speed of a runner.
But finds pleasure in those who fear the Lord, in those who await God's steadfast love. Hallelujah. Our second reading this morning comes from 1 Corinthians. If I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me, and woe to me if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the Jews I became as a Jew, in order to win the Jews. To those under the law, I became as one under the law, though I myself am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law, I became as one outside the law, though I am not free from God's law, but I am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak, I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. Lord of God, Word of God, Word of life.
The Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As soon as Jesus and the disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lift her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sunset, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons. And the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For there is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Praise be seated. Have you not heard? Have you not known? COVID-19 is a hoax. It's nothing more than a flu. It doesn't affect anyone. Doesn't change anything. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Those who are different from us are not worthy of our trust. Those who don't think like us are not credible. Those who don't look like us should not be heard. Have you not known? Have you not heard? God saves those who save themselves. God helps those who help themselves. Have you not know? Have you not heard? Put up yourself for your bootstraps. Have you not know? Have you not heard? The one The world belongs to the powerful, to the strong, and to the ones who survive, the ones who are self-made, the ones who got everything right, or the ones who do everything right. Have you not heard? If you are not a winner, you are a loser. If you are not the first, it's the same as being the last. Have you not heard that because of it, everything that's going wrong right here, right now, is someone else's fault? For the one belongs to the strong, for God supports the powerful, the one who does right, the one who pulls himself or herself for the bootstraps, the one who is self-made. God only favors those. God only loves those. If 2021 is supposed to be worse than 2020, have you not heard? Have you not know? It's someone else's fault. Perhaps it's God's fault. Except that for us, the Christian believer. And don't get me wrong, it's very easy to fall for that. Those forces that want us to tell these things and to proclaim those things and make those things true when they are lies, those things are powerful. They take over us, they take over communities, they pray out of fear. That God in some shape or form does not love us, that we are not beloved, that we fall behind, and we're going to be placed in this reality of eternal damnation that you can call that whatever you think it is. But the Bible tells us a different story that does not corroborate any of what we have heard before. We are not the first to fall to this trap when things are not going well. Remember, Isaiah, thousands of years ago, is writing to a community who has lost everything, who is in exile, and is very likely blaming everyone and everything else for what happened. Except that they have not followed through, or perhaps they have forgotten what they know and what have been told from the beginning. Have you not heard? Had it not been told to you by the Lord of your God, to you and me from the beginning? The God who creates everything, who provides everything, who loves us unconditionally and beyond repair. Have you not heard? The God does not faint. The God does not grow weary. That his understanding is unsearchable. and that he gives power to the faint. The God strengthens the powerless, even the young will be weary. Even the young will be exhausted. But have not you heard, have not been told you from the beginning that those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength? Have you not heard? Have you not known for a very long time, since the beginning, when you first learn about faith, that God comes down to bring good news to the brokenhearted, to the oppressed, to the sick, to the ones in prison, to the ones forgotten, to the ones who cannot help themselves, to the widow, to the orphan, to the ones in a dark spot, to the ones who fail and are broken. Have you not known, have you not been told from the beginning that Jesus, the Word of God coming to earth, who still has power, picks up us, the lowly, the struggling, the sick, the ones in despair, the ones without hope, the ones who have messed up, by their hand and lift us up and give us yet another chance? Have you not known? Have you not been told since the beginning that the love of your God for all his children is unconditional and everlasting? Have you not heard? Have you not known since the beginning that the Lord your God, and for us, the Christian church, his Son Jesus Christ, is the way to restore everything? Have you not known? Have you not heard since the beginning that we all shall mount up in wing like eagles, and shall run and not be weary, and shall walk and not faint? Regardless of who you are, regardless of what you have done, regardless of how many times you messed up, Lord your God loves you. It's his promise. He died for you and for me. Have you not known? Have you not been taught since the beginning to just love one another?
Thank you.
Together I invite you to profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, who was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Guided by the Christ made known to the nations, let us offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all people in need. For the church, for ministries of healing and wholeness, for hospital, hospice, and military chaplains, for those serving in prison ministry, and for all who proclaim freedom and release in the name of Christ. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For creation, for insects in the grass, for clouds on the mountaintops, for cattle and the rainwater they drink, for snow, for their humility to take our place among all creatures on earth. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For the nations, for all who live in cities and towns, states and countries, for community organizers, school officials and CEOs, for international health organizations, that in times of trial, fear, or hopelessness, they find freedom and serve to those most in need. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For all weary by life's burdens, for those who are poor, for those who lack in supportive relationships, for those crushed by debt, for those struggling with chronic pain or other sickness. For those exhausted from overwork or stress, and for all who cry out to you, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For this congregation, for endurance, wisdom, and peace in the face of the never-ending disruptions of our hopes as a faith community, for gratitude to those who insist on generously supporting us and staying connected. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
Beloved of God, you may now offer your own intercession. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
In thanksgiving for the faithful departed, who are called by name and now rest from their labors, that their lives serve as a witness to the goodness of God. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us. Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
At this point, as we move to the meal part of our service, if you want to partake in the Holy Supper with us, please make sure that you have wine, grape juice, a bread or a cracker with you. And as I elevate the elements, you may mimic that gesture at home. Make sure that you're hearing the words of institution. At that point, after we finish with the rite of Thanksgiving, you can then consume or share the elements at home. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them to the Lord.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right to give.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should, that at all times and in all places, give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, you are shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaim him your beloved Son. And in the miracle of water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join them. Amen. Amen. Jesus, your Son. He is your brightness, illuminating our shadows and revealing to us your mercy and might. In the night which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shared for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and the promise to come again. We await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By the Spirit, bless us in this meal, here or at our homes, that refreshed with this heavenly food, we may be a light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your Holy Church, both now and forever.
Amen.
Gathering to one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Beloved of God, here is bread and here is wine, here is Jesus. Be fed. Please stand if you are able. The bread and the cup of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in His grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Christ Jesus, at this table, we have feast in your very life and are strengthened for our journey. Set us forth for this banquet, nourished in body and spirit, to proclaim your good news and serve others in your name. Amen.
Amen.
We have quite a few announcements today, so bear with me. Announcement number one, Ash Wednesday, yes, it's coming, February 17th. You will have three opportunities to receive the imposition of ashes, if you will. Opportunity number one, you may take a small container with ashes for your household if you follow our service live on Ash Wednesday. You can make the imposition of ashes to the ones in your household, or perhaps upon yourself saying the words. The ashes are be available for you to pick up at church either next Sunday, the 14th, or Tuesday for any time in the day from 9 to 6. Tuesday is the day that I am here at the building. And I'll stay here until late because we have council. So pretty much if you stop by at any time beginning at 6 p.m., you just come through the door, pick up a little container of ashes that will be on the fellowship hall, and you can take them home. The second option to receive the imposition of ashes is going to be by drive-by. On Wednesday, I will be available from 12 until noon, and then for 3:30, 12 until 1 p.m., and for 3:30 until 4:30 p.m., I will be sitting by the church entrance, inside the building, of course. But if you drop by your vehicle and park by the front doors, I will go out and make the imposition of ashes on you. You don't need to leave your vehicle. It's going to be on Ash Wednesday from 12 to 1 or from 3:30 to 4:30. The third option, you can come. We're having worship in person with the COVID-19 restrictions. If that right is important and you want to do that with your faith community, you may still come. Our service will be at 6:30 p.m. on Ash Wednesday, February 17, and we will broadcast it live. Talking about broadcasting live, and I hope this will be enough notice. Beginning with our service on Ash Wednesday, we will switch out of Facebook. Don't panic. We will be broadcasting using a different media. We will be broadcasting using YouTube Live. Because believe it or not, there are some among us who are tech savvy, who will be able to watch if we broadcast on YouTube, but they have issues with social media and they don't want to participate in social media, things like Facebook, and that's fine. So, you will receive instructions of how to connect live through Facebook, through YouTube. So you don't need to worry about that. It's as simple as joining on Facebook. So again, beginning on Ash Wednesday, service, and the unfluent were changing from Facebook, from YouTube Live, if you are watching the live service. The recorded service, the recording of the service, will be posted on Facebook. So we're gonna have both options, but if you wanna watch live, the service will be on YouTube. Third announcement, bear with me, and then I promise I'll be done. Valentine's Day is approaching. It's gonna be next Sunday, the 14th. And perhaps it's been suggested out there, it is a great opportunity for us to show our homebound, people who have been already isolated since the COVID, before the COVID-19 hit, and now even more. So we'll be doing care baskets for them. You can come either anytime from 9 to 5, Tuesdays or Friday this week, or you can come to church during our Bible study. There will be baskets. So if you look to our list of homebound and people who are in nursing homes, we'll be making care packages for all of them. So if you wanna drop a card, if you wanna drop a Valentine gift, some of you may have like a Christian, those simple Christian gifts that we like to put with envelopes. Anything that reminds our homebounds that we are thinking about them, and we care for them, and God loves them too. You may suggest other people who may not be in the list. If that is the case, please communicate either me, myself, Joyce, or Brewer, or Judy Ellers, if you need to make an additional basket. More updates as we go in our Facebook page. I'm done. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thank you.
in peace, beloved of God, be the light for Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day, everyone.